Welcome to iLectureOnline. The result that we got for the total current and then the corresponding reactive power was that we had a current of 297.8 milliamps with a phase angle of 43.36 degrees, which gave us a power factor of 0.727. And let's say that we don't like that power factor. That's not a good power factor. We want it to be closer to one, to have less power loss, to have more efficiency. And so therefore, the question would then become, what kind of capacitor do we have to add to the three-phase system in order to have a larger power factor? In other words, a power factor of 0.9 means that we need to have a new phase angle of 25.84 degrees instead of the 43.36 degrees. Graphically, we have it like this. Let's say that here we have the old reactive power and we want the new reactive power to be smaller, so we need to have some additional reactive power added from the capacitor to negate that, so that from the old we get to the new, we get a smaller phase angle and therefore a larger power factor. So going back to some old equations, we need to remember that the current is equal to the voltage divided by the resistance, and in this case it's the voltage divided by the reactance of the capacitor, which can be written as 1 over omega c, where omega is equal to the radial frequency of the oscillations. For a 60 hertz circuit, that would be 60 hertz times 2 pi times the capacitor. So we can also write this as the voltage times omega times c, and that's going to be the current. We also know that we can relate the reactance to the power of the circuit. So if the power is I times V, then the reactance for a capacitor is also I times V. Or the current, if we only talk about the reactive power of the capacitor, will be the reactive power divided by V. If we now equate the current from this equation to the current from this equation, then we get V omega C from here said equal to Q over V from here. Remember, Q is the reactive power of the circuit, and added the added reactive power of the capacitor in this case. The capacitor to do that is going to be Q over omega V squared, and that's the key to finding the right capacitor. We also need to know that the reactive power of the capacitor can be found by saying I have the original power, which was 90,000 watts, or in this case, since we're talking about reactive power, it's 90,000 VAR, times the tangent of the old angle minus the tangent of the new angle. We want this to be a positive value, so we use positive angles to see the difference. Notice we go from the tangent of this, which is almost 1, minus the tangent of the new phase angle we want for a power factor of 0.9, and so that equals this. In other words, the total reactive power of the circuit is 41,400 VAR. But that's for all three phases of the circuit. To get that down to one of the phases, we need to divide that by 3. We have the 1/3 of the power in each phase, so therefore that's 13,800 VAR. If we take that value, divided by omega and V squared, remember the voltage was 240,000 volts on the circuit, we square that, 2 pi times the 60 hertz frequency on the circuit, that gives us a capacitor requirement of about 635 picofarads. If we add that capacitance to the three-phase system, we will increase the power factor from 0.727 to 0.9. And that's the methodology we use to find what capacitor we need to add to the circuit to get the power factor we want. And that is how it's done.